Like many of you, I grew up watching Disney movies. And, like many of you, I have a deep attachment to one Disney character in particular. Mine is Megara from the 1997 feature Hercules. While I admire Mulan's bravery and found a kindred spirit with Belle, Meg was the Disney heroine that I was always most drawn to because she's wildly unlike the rest of them.
Aren't you a damsel in distress?
I'm a damsel. I'm in distress. I can handle this. Have a nice day.
If we're looking at the range of Disney heroines, which I am defining as those in animated features who are canonically 16 years or older, they can all be easily designated into three categories. One, the more conventional heroines who are beautiful and graceful. Two, those who are awkwardly charming. And three, those who are strong or fierce. Of course, some Disney heroines overlap in these categories. For instance, Mulan is both awkwardly charming and strong. But Meg doesn't quite fit into any of these designations. She's beautiful, but not in the classic sense. She does have a few awkward moments, but for the most part is well composed. And she does stand up for herself, but isn't deeply passionate or physically strong. Rather, Meg is complicated, flawed, and wholly one of a kind within the Disney universe. First, let's consider Meg's appearance and character design as opposed to other Disney heroines. Visually, she's sharp and angular, with thin, arching eyebrows and long, knife-like fingers, rather than the softer or more athletic features of the other heroines. She also steers away from the often used doe-eyed animation, and instead features a sleeker cat eye that makes her appear a bit older than the other Disney heroines. All things considered, Meg's appearance is fairly predatory, which makes sense because
the character was likened after, you know, Barbara Stanwyck and the Lady Eve, and I'm diehard for all those 30s and 40s mobster movies and all the great dames of the era.
Stanwyck was one of the great actors of the film noir era, and has even been crowned noir's most notorious femme. In her book, Film Noir, Bad Girls of Film, Karen Burroughs Hansberry describes noir femmes as beguiling babes whose identities remain indelibly etched in our minds, like blood on a white satin pillowcase. I can't think of a better way to describe Meg. She's calculating and manipulative, but not without her vulnerable side, which makes her inherently contradictory and thus undeniably fascinating. Meg's noir femness comes out most notably in the scene right after she meets Hercules, where we discover that Meg is actually working for the villain Hades. There is no other Disney film in which a heroine begins her journey knowingly on the side of evil. And not only does Meg begin her journey with Hades, she continues to spy on and manipulate Hercules for him, for the better part of the film, knowing that Hercules might die as a result. If Pocahontas or Tiana or any other heroine were put in Meg's situation, they would have refused to do what Hades asked regardless of a contract, because they are morally steadfast. Meg, however, is not quite as virtuous as these other women, and so chooses self-preservation over moral integrity. This is not to say that the other Disney heroines are wrong for being so virtuous, but Megara shows the other side of the coin, the more intrinsically human side. Initially, she doesn't value integrity, isn't looking for love, and doesn't have any emotional attachments to the world, so her only option other than self-destruction is self-preservation. She cannot afford to be altruistic, and the moment that she is, the moment that she becomes like the other Disney heroines, it cost her her life.
Meg! No!
Meg's lack of any emotional attachment, friends,
my friends call me Meg, at least they would if I had any friends,
family, so even the cute sidekicks that every other Disney character seems to have, is what sets her most distinctly apart from the rest of Disney's women. While Elsa from Frozen does go through a similar period of damage and isolation, she always has her sister Anna, who is actively looking out for her.
You belong down in Arendelle. So do you.
While Meg has been without friends or family for what seems to be years.
Sometimes it's better to be alone.
What do you mean?
Nobody can hurt you.
She's had to make her own way without support or encouragement, knowing that she is alone. Meg has loved and lost before she ever met Hercules, implying that she's at least a few years older than him.
I'll have to ask you to release that young...
Keep moving, Junior.
Lady.
And older than the other Disney heroines, who all seem to be between 16 and 20 years old. She's learned not to trust men and doesn't balk when they make unwanted advances toward her because she's dealt with it before. Most significantly, Meg knows how to use her sexuality to manipulate, which implies that she may have had sexual relationships in the past.
Hey, I've sworn off manhandling.
She is the only heroine to ever have even the smallest suggestion of being anything other than a virgin. I am excluding the animal heroines in this statement because, as we see in both the Aristocats and the Lion King, they are not forced to follow the same moral rules around sex and childbearing as the human heroines. However, Meg is never put down nor puts herself down for being in control of her sexuality, even if she doesn't always use it responsibly. In many ways, Meg is Disney's anti-heroine. She's ambiguously moral instead of outrightly good.
If I say I want Wonder Boy's head on a platter, you say...
Medium or well done.
Her character design is much more stylized than any others, both in how she's animated and written. And she's had to become much more worldly than the others simply because she's been isolated by her past choices. While I do think that Mulan, Nala, Esmeralda, and many other Disney heroines are excellent role models, Meg is as well, because she teaches us that complicated, damaged people can heal and change.
You wanted to be petty and dishonest?
Everybody's not like that.
Yes, they are.
She shows us that you don't need to be perfectly good to be a good person, that it's okay to make mistakes.
Look, I know what I did was wrong, but this isn't about me, it's about him.
That it's also okay not to be nice all the time.
You're really choked up about this, aren't you?
Come on!
And that just because you've done bad things doesn't mean you don't deserve to be happy at the end of it all.
I wish to stay on Earth with her. I finally know where I belong.
If you want to see more about Meg and Hercules, you can check out the part 2 to this video, which will be out very soon, where I'll be comparing Meg's and Hercules' hero journeys. Make sure to like and subscribe if you enjoyed this video, and thank you so much for watching.